started, sir.
This is P. Srinivas. I have been working as a lecturer for 13 years, and I am going to teach accountancy for entrance first year. Here, accountancy or accounting is the business language. That's why when business is developing, equal to that accountancy also is developing. That's why here accountancy is a separate branch in the commerce. Here the subject accountancy has also a father. The father of accountancy is Father Luca Facioli. It belongs to Italy. It is in the continent of the Europe. Here, the main objective of accountancy is no profit of the business organization. That's why there is some process occurred in accountancy or in accounting. Here, accounting is defined as it is the recording clarifying and summarizing of all the financial transaction and also give results to the users. Once to come to the definition, accounting is a recording. Here in accounting, all the business transactions are recording in a book that is called the journal. That is called the journal. Because human memory is limited, so the remembering all the business transactions in keeping mind is difficult. That's why it is a recording in the first book. It is called the journal. So in the journal, total business transactions are recorded in the form of the entries. In the form of the entry, so that is the first phase in accounting that is recorded. Next, clarify. All the business transactions are clarified into according to the nature of the business transaction, either personal, real, and nominal accounts. So, and also they formed all the entries in the form of the ledger. That's why classification of accounts all are comes into the ledger. So, ledger is nothing but a group of accounts. Okay? As per the classification, they will be personal, real, and nominal. And then these classification is posting into the ledger. So, this is the second and also final entry book in a ledger. Next one, summarizing. The total ledger balances are to be shown in the form of the summary in a special book that is called a trial balance. That's why summarizing is also done in the phase of the trial balance or in the form of the trial balance. Trial balance nothing but all the balances are to be trial to make equal to equalization of all debit and credit balances in this trial balance to prepare final accounts. Why? Because in accountancy the final accounts are finally prepared. To that the process is compulsory. First one journal, second one ledger, and next trial balance. Okay, here the result is to be shown. The result is nothing but a profit or loss. The result is profit or loss of organization, and it is shown to its users. Generally, the accountancy or the accounting users are business organizations or commercial organizations, as well as banks, employees, creditors, all these are the users who can use this accountancy. The result will be shown by the accounting. So this is the total accounting is studied now in a definition. Okay. So next here is let us discuss here accounting concepts. See here, our father of accounting is introduced in some accounting concepts. Okay, concepts are universal followed by each and every concern in their accounting practices. Okay, here there are some accounting concepts which are followed by business organization now to be discussed here. First one, business entity concept. Business entity concept. Okay, concepts are also called as the postulates. As for this, business is an entity. Entity means a separate person. Okay, here who is a separate person? Business entity and a business is a separate person to the proprietor. Okay, now here proprietor is nothing but also called as the owner of the business. Okay, or a trader of the business is called the proprietor. Here business is a separate person to its producer or its trader. Okay, now that's why here business transactions are recorded separately to owner's personal index or owner's practices. Okay, as per business entity concept, here the amount introduced by the proprietor, because without proprietor, without owner, there is no operation of the business. That's why initially amount introduced by the proprietor is called the capital. Is called the capital. Okay. And also, in the business point of view, the amount introduced by the proprietor is giving benefit. That's why he is called as a creditor to the business organization. In practice, he is the owner to the business. But as per accounting, he is separate person. That's why the amount introduced by him is called a creditor. Okay? And also, all the personal transactions, all personal uses made from the organization by the proprietor is called as the drawings. Is called as drawings. Okay, on drawings, on capital, the business organization is charged interest as well as the received interest from proprietor or from the business owner. So this is about a business entity concept. Okay, credit and debt, business entity concept. Okay, vyapara vyaktitva bhavana ledha astitva bhavana antaru ikkada enti ante nidaniki owner lekunda business nadavadu kaani accountancy prakaram entante owner ni business ni veriga chudalani cheptundi mari owner veriga chusinappudu ayana introduce chesinatundi amount ni ayana introduce chesinatundi investment ni manam em anukovali ante capital anukovali okana ayana tara sundaniki ఆర్గనైజేషన్ అమౌంట్ తీసుకున్నప్పుడు దాన్ని డ్రాయింగ్స్ కానీ చెప్పడం జరుగుతుంది. ఓకే, అయితే పర్సనల్ ట్రాన్సాక్షన్ని బిజినెస్ ట్రాన్సాక్షన్ని మనం వేరుగా చూపాలి. ఎందుకంటే ట్రూ అండ్ ఫెయిర్ పొజిషన్ తెలవాలి అంటే సపరేట్ ఆర్గనైజేషన్ అండ్ వాళ్ళ ప్రొప్రైటర్ రికార్డ్స్ మనం మెయింటైన్ చేయాలని చెప్తుంది ఈ బిజినెస్ ఎంటిటీ కాన్సెప్ట్. ఓకే, ద సెకండ్ వన్ నౌ ఇట్ ఈస్ మనీ మెజర్మెంట్ కాన్సెప్ట్. Money measurement concept. Here, as name implies in the concept, total business transactions are measured in terms of money. In terms of money, okay, which are not financial nature or which are not monetary transactions, all they are ignored as per our financial accounting. Why? Because the financial transactions are only considered, okay, which are non-monetary things. They are completely ignored as per this concept. So it means the quantity, quality, and meters, kilometers, liters, some these quantities completely ignored. But regarding this, whatever is the price paid by the proprietor or price received by the proprietor, all are to be recorded in this, okay, as per this concept in the books of account. So this is the second concept. Next, third one, cost concept. Cost concept. దీని వ్యయ భావన అంటాము. ఈ ముందుగానే ఒక మనీ మెజర్మెంట్ కాన్సెప్ట్, ద్రవ్య కొలమాన భావనని చెప్పడం జరుగుతుంది. అంటే ప్రతి ట్రాన్సాక్షన్ ని, ప్రతి వస్తువును కాకుండా దాని ధరను మనం తీసుకోవాలి దీంట్లో. ఇక్కడ కాస్ట్ కాన్సెప్ట్ అంటే హియో వెన్ ద ప్రైస్ పెయిడ్ బై ద ప్రొపరేటర్ టు యాన్ అసెట్ ఆర్ టు ఎ థింగ్ దోస్ ఒరిజినల్ వాల్యూస్ ఆర్ ఓన్లీ రికార్డెడ్ as per cost concept. Okay, so as per cost concept here, amount which amount is paid by the proprietor for purchasing, those values are only recorded. Okay, even though there is increasing or decreasing in the value of the asset or in the value of the thing, they are completely ignored, but original price paid to that only is recorded as per cost concept. It means increasing price, decreasing price of the asset or thing is not recorded at all. That is as per cost concept. Okay, oka vastunu gaani aastini gaani manam ee dharaite unnamo ee samvatsaramlo unnamo ade dharanu manu cheppali kaani ippudu present market price veriga undani ekko cheppadam takko cheppadam cheyaradu ani cheppetvandi concept entante cost concept. Okay, so the next one is here going concern concept. Going concern concept. Okay, దీని గతిశీల సంస్థ భావన అంటాము. ఇక్కడ going ఒక కాన్సెప్ట్. కాన్సెప్ట్ ఇంకా నథింగ్ బట్ బిజినెస్ ఆర్గనైజేషన్. బిజినెస్ ఆర్గనైజేషన్ ఈజ్ గోయింగ్ మీన్స్ ఇట్ ఈస్ కంటిన్యూడ్. ఒక ఇట్ ఈస్ కంటిన్యూడ్. ఇట్ ఈస్ సెట్ బై అవర్ going concern concept. Ante what does it mean here? It is, well, the organization is entered into market, it will be presumed or it is assumed I will be continue in the business in long run. I will be continue long run in the business, then only it will be, okay, face all challenges faced in the market. Okay, right here. Ante how much of business is continued up to that, as per this concepts, there are some assets, some liabilities also involved here. As per going concern concept, the term of assets and liabilities are introduced here. So here, as per going concern concept, business is a continuous process. But how much of the business continue up to that, the owner or the organization has some properties and fixed assets. Okay, so that's why as per going concern concept, assets and liabilities are introduced here. Assets are divided into two categories as current assets as well as fixed assets. Current assets and fixed assets. Now all these are, we are introduced and we are recording in the final accounts. In the final accounts. So that's why the importance of assets is in introduced or explained in going concern concept only. Current assets. Okay, the asset which is converted easily into cash is called current assets. Okay, as per this cash, bank balance, debtors, bills receivable, investment, all are taken as current assets here. Next, fixed assets. Okay, so it is defined as which has durability or the thing or the asset which is used or which is used in production and services, they are taken as fixed assets. Okay, and also liabilities are also taken as liabilities are also taken as short term liabilities as well as long term liabilities. शॉर्ट टर्म एंड लॉन्ग टर्म, शॉर्ट टर्म लायबिलिटीज एंड लॉन्ग टर्म लायबिलिटीज। लॉन्ग टर्म लायबिलिटीज ओके, अरे विच इज टू बी पेएबल इन द शॉर्ट टर्म मींस विद इन द 1 ईयर और अप टू 1 ईयर, दे आर कॉल्ड शॉर्ट टर्म लायबिलिटी एंड एक्सेस ऑफ 1 ईयर अटे मोर देन 1 ईयर पीरियड इज कंसीडर्ड टू लॉन्ग टर्म लायबिलिटी। हियर शॉर्ट टर्म लायबिलिटीज आर सन्ड्री क्रेडिटर्स नेक्स्ट बिल्स पेएबल एंड बैंक ओवरड्राफ्ट आर टेकन शॉर्ट टर्म एंड बैंक लोन्स एंड सम अदर लॉन्ग टर्म लोन्स आर टेकन एज लॉन्ग टर्म लायबिलिटी। नेक्स्ट द कॉन्सेप्ट हियर इज matching concept. So here, as per this concept, in accounting or in accountancy, there are some R to be mapped here. He hyper maps the concept to expenses with income, R to be mapped. Okay, basically, in accounting, side by side, we are recording. Okay, expenses are recorded on the left side, incomes are recorded on the right side, and side by side, we have to be mapped here. We are mapped here. So, and I put this concept, expenses are matched with incomes, and also liabilities are also recorded with assets. Liabilities are also recorded with assets. You see the take it, I put matching concept only. That's why we are recording in final accounts. In final accounts, expenses are left side, incomes are credit side. Liabilities are left side, assets are right side. So these are totally about the accounting concepts.